friends, welcome back to our discussion on the core values at Central Assembly of God. We have talked about hungry hearts or desiring to be filled by God with His knowledge and love and peace. Next, we went over attentive eyes. This is where we see people who are in need and try to meet those needs. And, of course, keep our eyes on the Lord and what He has for us. After that, we went over linked arms. This has us joining with the people around us to build relationships and hold each other up by using our words and actions. Remember, we are all part of something bigger than ourselves. We are part of the body of Christ, which is also known as the church or Christians. We all must strive to work together to not only spread the good news, but to live it too. Today, we're going to talk about having open hands. What do open hands look like? When I open my hands, I can both give to others and receive things from other people. When my hands are closed, I'm not ready to give or receive anything. We spoke a few weeks ago about being generous. Remember the kids' meal? We had a 6-piece nugget, and we give 4 to another kid who looks hungry. We are being generous, because even though we are hungry, and we really could use all 6 nuggets, we're giving more to the child that is hungry than we are getting ourselves. That's being generous. The Bible speaks many times about people being generous. 1 Kings 17:7-16 talks about Elijah. God sent him to a certain place to meet with a widow who needed food for her and her son. God was going to give her what she needed in a very special way. Now, there had been a drought or no rain for a very long time. Elijah went to the place God had told him to go and wait. There he saw a widow collecting sticks. He asked her if she could get him some water and maybe some bread. The woman replied sadly that she only had some flour and oil. She was collecting sticks to make a fire so she could cook one last meal for her and her son. After that, they would starve, for she had no other way to get food. Can you imagine? This mother who loved her son dearly was preparing for what she thought would be his last meal. We are so blessed when we can take care of one another and provide food and clothing and homes for our families. It's not like that for everyone in the world. Elijah told the woman that if she made some bread and brought him a piece, she would never run out of ingredients. The widow did what he asked, giving him some of her precious bread. It must have taken a lot of faith to give part of what she thought was her last meal to a complete stranger. But she did it. That, my friends, is generosity. She gave what she didn't have enough of to a stranger who needed it. You know what, though? God always keeps His promises. We keep hearing that over and over again, don't we? Yes, God always keeps His promises. The widow's supply of oil and flour never, ever ran out. Her jars were full. Elijah's hands were open to obey God and do what He said. The widow's hands were open to help Elijah with what he needed. And God's hands are forever open to meet our needs in the best way possible. Guys, let's always have open hands for one another and those around us. Let's be generous with our time and our toys and our food and our money. We are all part of the most special family around, the family of God. In everything we do, we should represent Jesus in everything He is. He is definitely loving and generous. He builds relationships with us and with others. Our remember verse for this series is Ephesians 4:16. Christ holds a body together and makes all of its parts work perfectly as it grows and becomes strong because of love. Having open hands is part of being the body or church of Jesus. Let's all keep that in mind. Remember, kids, I love you, and God loves you too. Bye, guys.